What is up? My name is Martin and today we're going to take a look at the Xiaomi Philips Smart LED Bedside Lamp with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. And this is a variant on the already existing Xiaomi and Ulite bedside lamps that I have over here as well. But this one has a few tweaks here and there and it is $20 more expensive. So let's get started. Okay, so let's get straight into it. So on top of the lamp, you've got this very nice and tactile button for the power on and the power off, and it works really well and easy, and also it remembers your last choice in hue and brightness. So if you rotate the lamp, the brightness will go lower or higher. And if you press the button for 3 seconds, you will enter my most favorite mode. It's some sort of a nightlight mode, and it's even softer than the lowest setting that you can set manually. I like it more than the Xiaomi bedside lamp because the brightness is lower and it is shifting nicely to the top. It is relaxing during evening or night and I'm very happy and satisfied with it. Now you can also tap the button twice and then you will enter the color mode. Yeah. So rotating here will change the brightness again, and if you press plus hold the button and rotate the lamp, you can pick any kind of color anywhere ranging from 1700 to 6500 Kelvin. Now I have to be honest, this lamp is so easily manually controlled that I barely use the application, and if you want you can use the Mi Home application. So grab your phone and download the Mi Home application, and you want to open the application from there. And then you want to add a device by clicking on the plus icon over there. And then most likely you will find the lamp right away. They will ask you to provide access to your Wi-Fi network. So let's do it so you can easily can control it later on. And it takes around 1 minute to complete the internet setup process. You can then add it to a room so you can group your devices. And here you can start to control the light. So you can change the color easily by dragging the pointer onto the palette. And if you go to the third menu, you can set the brightness anywhere from 1% to 100%. And if you go to CCT, which means that it's correlated color temperature, you can differentiate the various hues of white. And the first menu item is of course how you can turn on or off the lamp. Xiaomi and Philips also pre-made a lot of scenes, as you can see over here. And then we have the sleep and wake menu items, which are great features to be honest, because you can set countdowns in order to turn on or off the lamp with either a dimming sunset light to drift off to sleep, or you can set a color at sunrise to waken you. And from the settings menu, you can change, for example, the bedside lamp's its settings itself to enable smart midnight light. You can connect it to your Mi Band 3, for example. When you're asleep, the lamp will turn off automatically, or you can set a timer, for example. You can also set automation rules, so if, for example, the temperature goes above a certain degree, the lamp will turn red, and you can also connect it to the weather or the actual weather situation, for example. And you can also secure the lamp from the settings menu or share it with someone else, so you can both use the lamp or use it as a gateway, and maybe that explains why the price is a bit higher, because now you can connect other devices via the lamp as well. You can also update the lamp, and that's basically all what I think is what you need to know for this application. It works pretty well, and just like all the other applications from Xiaomi, it just does a job. And I have to be honest, it looks like the Ulite application because it works really smooth. It has the same similar design, etc., but it works just great. Okay, Google, turn off the Philips light. That is one of the things what I don't like about this lamp. There is no integration with any kind of assistant. So Google Assistant or Alexa, or maybe you use Bixby or Microsoft Cortana. But anyways, none of them are supported for now. I hope maybe later on, because that's one of the things I miss. And the other thing that I miss is a battery inside. It doesn't have to be a huge battery, but at least like 2 hours or 3 hours would be nice. So if you have children, you can just give them the lamp, and if they go to the toilet, they can bring it along, for example. Or when you go hiking and with the tent, it would be nice if there's a small battery inside. Maybe it doesn't fit inside, I didn't open it yet, but that's one of the suggestions and things that I'm thinking about that could be improved. So if you do decide to purchase this lamp, this is the box where you receive it in. You have an image on the front and there are some specifications on the rear in Chinese. but I will list all the specifications and the current price in the video's description, so make sure you check it out. And inside the box you will first find the instruction manual in Chinese. And then you find some sort of a small box on top that contains the power plug. And it is with the Type-C plug, but you cannot use your smartphone charger because it needs at least 12 volts. And then we also have the lamp itself, of course. It is well protected with some nice plastic. And that's basically all what you find in the box. So in the end, it's up to you to decide if you think it's worth this extra $15 or $20, depending on the current price, of course, but you can find it in the video's description. I think that in terms of light and the transmission of it, it looks way better than the Xiaomi Mi Jia Light, and you got a full one instead of with this little base over there. But then on the other hand, you don't get the assistant integration, and I do, to be honest, miss a small battery inside. Either way, that's it for today. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below, because I'm always hanging out down there. Once again, thank you so much for watching this video, and then I hope to see all of you in the next one.